the Packer and Murdoch media empires won't tell how young Lachlan and James have lost Aussie battlers a fortune.
You can join forces all you like, but not when you then have to go to some poor pensioner somewhere and say, hey guys, how would you like to buy a few pieces of paper?
How the so-called whiz kids got sucked in by the old school tie. Hello, I'm Naomi Robson. But first, the OneTel collapse, and the Murdoch and Packer families won't like this story, and you won't read about it in the Murdoch press or see it on the Packer television network. James Packer and Lachlan Murdoch have been pointing the finger at OneTel whiz kids Jody Rich and Brad Keeling and crying foul. They claim they've been profoundly misled. But that's little consolation to the tens of thousands of Aussie battlers who lost their money when the telephone company collapsed. As Norm Beeman reports, it may be convenient, but it's not that easy to shift the blame.
The elite Cranbrook Boys School is a who's who of who's privileged in Australia. The school in Sydney's exclusive eastern suburbs fosters networks of power and influence. It's not just a case of what you know, but who you can get to know. And when it comes to the rich list, Cranbrook is at the top of the class. Three former students who fit the criteria on every count are James Packer, son of Kerry, media and gambling magnate, Rodney Adler, son of the late Larry Adler, founder of insurance company FAI, and Jody Rich, son of Stephen Rich, founder of travel group Travelland. Jody Rich is the co-founder of OneTel.
We had Rodney Adler, whose name's been quite prominent of late. He and Jody Rich and James all knew each other through what's called the Cranbrook Circle. They all mixed in that Sydney eastern suburbs social clique.
John Dury is from the Fairfax-owned Financial Review.
Through that friendship, I think Jody was able to convince James of what a great idea he had, and then James and Lachlan obviously saw a lot of each other, and that drew those two together.
Throw in another chum, Lachlan Murdoch. He spent his schooling years overseas, but any friend of James Packer with the name Murdoch has an open invitation to the exclusive boys' club.
I think if you don't live here, you're just camping out.
These young movers and shakers are the key players in OneTel, the telephone company that hit the wall, and a big slice of $1 billion is at stake. Packer and Murdoch are not the biggest losers. News Limited and Publishing and Broadcasting are publicly owned companies. Tens of thousands of Australian mums and dads, many having invested in superannuation funds backing the Packer-Murdoch names, are the people who will feel the pinch, and also people who directly invested into OneTel.
Well, mums and dads shareholders are clearly the big losers. People who followed them into the stock, they don't have the billions of dollars behind them to compensate for losses like this.
Jody Rich was a hunted man today. His mansion was staked out, and the big fingers of James Packer and Lachlan Murdoch were being pointed directly at him. The word misled was becoming a cliche in the Murdoch press and on Packer television. But others wouldn't buy it.
They did achieve what they wanted to achieve. Precisely. They got the share price from nothing to nothing. I mean, what more brilliant success do you want than that?
Jonar Nader is a finance expert and author.
What I care is that somewhere along the line, your grandmother and mine put their last little few cents of saving in it on the back of, wow, the brand, we've got Packer and Murdoch behind it. What better brand name can you want in a marketplace? And what's your grandma and mine going to do? They're going to be ripped off. That's what they're going to do.
There's no doubt the Packer and Murdoch names enticed investors to back OneTel.
Yeah, definitely.
Why's that?
Well, I presume with the resources that they have, that they would research a company properly.
It's very surprising that two so well-connected people could make the mistakes. But it just goes to show you that even the big boys can lose it, like the average punters.
Jody Rich and Brad Keeling have a lot to answer for. But young Packer and Murdoch also face scrutiny.
But they'd be liable to any claims that people might make against the company. And these would be claims that investors may have made on the basis of their involvement in the company or on the grosses of a negligence claim. That's a big ask at this stage of the game, but potentially, yes.
It's hard to imagine James and Lachlan's fathers will be impressed.
In the case of the Murdoch family, there's a bit of a question mark over who's going to replace Rupert, but Lachlan's seen as the favourite at the moment. And clearly people are going to sort of keep remembering this OneTel disaster. And likewise, James was very much the new technology champion in his family, and his father was always a sceptic. And so he's obviously going to have to do a bit of talking with his father, I would think, to to prove that new technology is actually the money spinner he says it is.
Norm Beeman reporting there. Now to Australia's biggest home builder, Henley Homes.